Right. There is honor even in rank violence. There is honor in war. But no military doctrine, ladies and gentlemen, no book of war anywhere in the world has ever advocated mutilating and beheading an enemy soldier. That's not what professional armies do. That is not what professional soldiers do. Yes, there is an army that does that. It's called ISIS. There is another army that believes in this philosophy of mutilation and beheading. It's called the Taliban. The Pakistan army seems to be taking a leaf out of the playbook of ISIS and Taliban. Today they beheaded two Indian soldiers, one from the BSF, one from 22 Sikh. And the Pakistan army is so shameless that it doesn't even have the spine to own up to this heinous act. The Indian government says there will be swift and severe retaliation for this. But ladies and gentlemen, the country's patience is wearing thin. We have had one terror attack after another, from Pathankot to Uri to Kupwada just last week. Is it finally time to call out this treacherous double game by Pakistan? Is it time to end this once and for all? Is it time for the ultimate face-off? Depraved Pakistan army shows its barbaric side yet again in Kashmir. The border action team of the Pakistan army violates the LOC ceasefire. It kills an army officer and a BSF head constable and then mutilates their bodies. India retaliates with heavy firing at the point of infiltration. And we'll be putting that to our guest panel tonight. How much more can we take? How much more do we have in our reserves of patience? Is enough been taken already? Has the time come for the final showdown to teach Pakistan a lesson once and for all? We'll be joined here in our studios by Major General Rajesh Arya, defense analyst. Jeevil Narasimha Rao, spokesperson of the BJP, will be joining us. Jaiveer Shergill, Supreme Court lawyer and spokesperson of the Congress. Vivek Kaju, former secretary in the Ministry of External Affairs, will also be joined by Taimur Shamil from Pakistan. And Harkishan is the uncle of Lance Naik Hemraj, who was killed in much the same fashion 4 years ago in 2013. So are we to answer Pakistan in a language that it understands? Is it time for that famous 10 heads for one response? Is it time for an eye for an eye? You can vote for the best debater, the person who you felt most convinced by his or her arguments. You can vote on our Facebook page, on our Twitter page. It's the pinned tweet there. You can also go to our landing website, news18.com. Well, that's our big focus, and we'll get to our face-off in just a couple of minutes. Here are the other headlines that we're tracking this Monday night on Face-Off. Terrorists gunned down five policemen and two guards of a cash van in broad daylight in Kulgam. Hizbul Mujahideen claims responsibility for the attack. The Aam Aadmi Party is split wide open. 37 party MLAs have asked the top leadership to expel Amanatullah Khan for making allegations against Kumar Vishwas. Kejriwal issues gag orders. Kumar Vishwas refuses to attend a crucial PAC meeting till action is taken against Amanatullah Khan. There's no end to the Supreme Court versus Justice C.S. Karnan war of words. The Supreme Court orders a psychological examination of the Calcutta High Court judge. He's to be mentally examined on the 4th of May. Justice Karnan refuses. He terms the 7-judge Supreme Court bench corrupt. Evidence of massive corruption against RJD chief Lalu Prasad Yadav during UPA1 when he was Railways Minister. Documents accessed by CNN News 18 show senior RJD leaders actually gifted land to Lalu Prasad Yadav's family in lieu of ministerial berths. Once again, the Pakistan Army and security forces have proven themselves to be a band of barbaric savages. They've junked the rules of engagement at the high-tension line of control in a despicable, unsoldierly act. Today, Pakistan's border action team resorted to the mutilation of two Indian soldiers, one a Naib Sumedar, another a BSF head constable. This after Pakistan violated the ceasefire, fired rocket and mortar shells, and barged 200 meters into the Indian side in Poonch district's Krishna Ghati sector. The two Indian martyrs were on patrol duty at that time, and just hours later, the Indian Army hit back, unleashing its firepower on Pakistani posts along the line of control. The Indian Army has assured that there will be a strong and swift response.
The government of India strongly condemns this act, and the whole country has full confidence and faith in our armed forces, which will react appropriately to this inhuman act. The sacrifice of these two soldiers will not go in vain.
We will respond appropriately to this inhuman act. The sacrifice of these two soldiers will not go in vain. That's the Defense Minister, Arun Jaitley. But what really are India's options? How will India strike back? Option one is an artillery attack on the Pakistani post from where this attack was launched. We've already got word from the Defense Ministry that there is heavy firing happening at that infiltration point. This, of course, violates the 2003 ceasefire. But what good is that ceasefire if it doesn't protect our jawans, if it leads to the beheading and the mutilation of our jawans? Option two is covert operations, cross-border raids, much like the surgical strikes which got publicized post facto. This is a likely option, not least because this is now a part of India's military doctrine. India has experience in surgical strikes, most notably on the 29th of September last year. So this is a likely option. Option three is to raise this issue at the International Court of Justice. This is an unlikely option. India doesn't want to internationalize the Kashmir issue. Option four is to raise this with the Pakistanis at a flag meeting. Remember, the DGMOs have a mechanism. They meet once every week. This is, again, unlikely. It's ineffective. It's been tried in the past, but it's made little headway. And option five is to completely snap diplomatic ties. Why should we have a 100-strong Pakistani High Commission here in Delhi? Why should we have an Indian mission in Islamabad? Isn't it time to put an end to bilateral talks, expel the High Commissioner? This shutdown, of course, has a limited window, which means, again, it's unlikely to be carried out. The last time it was carried out was during Operation Parakram back in 2002. And option six, finally, is limited airstrikes on targets in Pakistan. This, again, was discussed in the aftermath of 26/11. At that time, the response of the UPA was, we don't have the capabilities. Has it changed? The government certainly has changed. It's a more muscular, more nationalistic government. Is this option now on the table? We'll be putting that and more to our special guest joining us on Face Off tonight here in our studios, Major General Rajesh Arya, defense analyst, GVL Narasimha Rao, spokesperson of the BJP, Jaiveer Shergill, Supreme Court lawyer and spokesperson of the Congress, Vivek Arju, former MEA secretary. Harkishan is Hemraj's uncle, Lance Naik Hemraj, who was beheaded in much the same fashion as these two soldiers were today. This was back in 2013. He's joining us from Mathura. And Taimur Shamil is joining us from Lahore. Major General, you've been a lifelong army man. What sort of army, sir? What sort of professional army? The statement that was put out by the DGISPR today, that Pakistan Army is a professional army. What sort of professional army beheads an enemy soldier, sir?
Zaka, before I commence, my salute to the martyrs and my deep condolence to the families who sacrificed their life once again on the call of the nation. And with your permission to their sacrifices, I would like to surrender 5 seconds of your channel in their sacrifices. Zaka, we must acknowledge openly now that we have an uncivilized nation state on our western borders.
Yes.
And I don't recognize it by that name what it has. I would like to call it a Zalimstan, because it is a state which is imploding. It is a state which is, if not failed, failing. It is a state which is a blot on humanity.
You're a blot on humanity, Taimur Shamil. Your country is a blot on humanity. You should be called Zalimstan, not Pakistan, Taimur Shamil. What sort of country,
no,
what sort of professional
no.
army, sir, beheads
no
an
Pakistani
enemy soldier.
Soldier? No Pakistani soldier, Zaka, would ever mutilate a dead body.
Oh,
this
please.
Is unlike
Why
a
don't
Pakistani
you ask the family
soldier.
Of Captain Saurabh Kalia
time,
that?
There is no evidence.
Why don't you ask the family of Lance Nayak Hemraj that?
A tweet
you have some
work.
Lofty ideas of what the Pakistan army
work.
Does and doesn't
and that
do.
Is the issue.
I am sorry, Taimur Shamil, you might be living in some alternative reality about your army. But I think Major General Arya is 100% right. You should be called a Zalimstan. That's the name for your country and for your army. Do you believe in the ISIS philosophy? Do you believe in the ISIS philosophy? Do you believe in the Taliban philosophy? They believe in beheadings. They believe in mutilations, Taimur Shamil. They believe in beheadings and mutilations.
Pakistan would give
One second, Taimur Shamil. Because you're living in this distorted reality about your own army, let me give you an example of what your army does. We have with us Himraj's uncle. One second, listen to me. Listen to me. I have an Indian martyr's family member with me. You will listen to him, okay? You will listen to him. We have Lance Nayak Hemraj's uncle joining us, Mr. Harkishan. Sir, bahut bahut dhanyawad aapka. Aap hamare program se jud gaye hain. Aap hamare Pakistani mehman jo hai is program mein shamil hain, unko zara bataiye. Lance Nayak Hemraj, unke saath kya hua? Wo kehte hain ki Pakistan army kabhi kisi ke sar nahi kaatti, kisi ke body ko mutilate nahi karti. Aapke bhanja ke saath kya hua? Bataiye unko zara.
लेकिन इस बात का सबूत
नो नो हैंग ऑन लेट हिम स्पीक लेट हिम स्पीक लेट हिम स्पीक हरकिशन जी बताइए
हाँ जी बताऊं
जी बताइए बताइए
हमारे जो भाई हमारा जो बेटा का हेमराज को जो सिर कटे हुआ टाइम जब यहाँ बड़े बड़े नेता आए राजनाथ भी आए करकड़ी भी आए पर सब झूठे आश्वासन दे गए हमारे बेटा को जब सिर काट दियो तो हमने हमसे ये वायदा करे जो हमारी जो सरकार होती तो हम एक सर के 10 सर बदलो ले लेते
जी
आज तक उनने एको तो बदलो ना लियो सब झूठे सांसे वायदा करे हमसे और अब दो सिर हमारे हिंदुस्तान के फिर ले गए तो अब ऐसे जो सिर काट लेंगे तो हमारे हिंदुस्तान तो नहीं बर्बाद हो जाएगा
तो क्या करना हमारी क्या करनी चाहिए आप बताइए देश को क्या करनी चाहिए सरकार को क्या करनी चाहिए बताइए वन सेकंड टाइम शामिल यू विल लिसन टू हिम ऑलराइट यू विल लिसन टू हिम हरकिशन जी बताइए देश को क्या करनी चाहिए सरकार को क्या करनी चाहिए बताइए
देश को सरकार को ये करना चाहिए ये पाकिस्तान के एक के बदले में 20 तो मरेंगे और इनके 20 इनके सिर कटे इनके और इनकी छूट दे दी जाए इन्हें छूट हमारी हिंदुस्तान को छूट ही ना दे रहे
Taimur Shamil I'm warning you for the last time you will not interrupt a martyr's family a martyr's kin when he's speaking on this channel all right I'm not going to say this again please treat him with the respect that he deserves Harkishan ji आप बताइए आप पूरी कीजिए आपकी बात
आप हम यहाँ कहना चाह रहे हैं हमारे जो हिंदुस्तान के जो जवान ने मार रहे हैं ये पाकिस्तान के जवान कैसे ना मारे जा रहे हैं हमारे हिंदुस्तान के इन पर इनको कार्रवाई करो शासन ढीलो मत छोड़ो देखो सरकार क्यों ढीला पर नहीं है पहले जो वायदा करे वो पूरे भेजना अब फिर सिर काट दिए तो कम से कम अब इनके एक के बदले में दो दो तीन तीन तो इनके सिर काटो साले इनके
पूछते हैं जीवीएल नरसिम्हा राव से पूछते हैं जीवीएल नरसिम्हा राव भाजपा का प्रवक्ता है जीवीएल योर लीडर नाउ द एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स मिनिस्टर शी वॉज LOP इन द लोकसभा फोर ईयर्स अगो शी वेंट टू हेमराज हाउस शी मेट हरकिशन जी एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द फैमिली एंड शी सेड एक सर के बदले 10 सर लेके आएंगे व्हाट हैपेंड टू दैट जीवीएल व्हाट हैपेंड टू दैट
हाँ हमें बड़ो आस बहुत बड़ो भरोसा बीजेपी सरकार को बहुत बड़ो
हरकिशन जी ने जो बात कही मैं उनको उनके सम्मान करता हूँ मार्टिर के फैमिली से हैं उनके उनके चाचा हैं तो इनके बात पर मैं कोई पॉलिटिकल प्रतिक्रिया नहीं देना चाहूंगा बट लेकिन इतना मैं उनको कहना चाहूंगा our government has what we have stated in the opposition is what we have practiced as a government ruling government at the center there is no dichotomy but we are in government we will speak what is to be spoken but we have certainly demonstrated through surgical strikes and through other actions that this government has not tied the hands of the army behind its back They have been empowered. They have been. That's the reason why there have been attempts at infiltration over the last 2 years. Because our army dealt with every attempt at infiltration with a heavy response.
But GVL doesn't seem to be working.
It doesn't seem to be working, GVL.
That is the problem. I don't think Pakistan has got the message from the surgical strikes. I think it's time for stronger action.
They have got. You see, if you look at the 3 months before the surgical strikes and 3 months thereafter, or period thereafter, certainly the attempt infiltration attempts have come down, ceasefire fire violations have come down,
okay,
their ability to sneak in terrorists has come down. But certainly you are dealing with not an army. This itself, we so far thought Pakistani army is actually supporting terrorist outfits like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed. But today you, Jamaat-ud-Dawah, today you realize the Pakistani army itself is a terror outfit.
Of course it is.
I think it doesn't, it's not bound. It's not bound the, by
any
rules of a professional army.
It's not. Taimur,
so therefore,
Shamil, you can continue
indulge,
to live.
They will indulge
you
in
can
such
continue
acts
to live in,
and they will have to be ripped
in your own cooked up reality about the Pakistani army. You know what Article 16
BJP,
of the Geneva Convention BJP, says, Taimur Shamil? Article 16 of the Geneva Convention says,
BJP
and this, by the way,
won.
Hang on a second, Taimur. Hang on a second. Hang on a second. One second. Hang on a second. Hang on one second. Mr. Shamil, just have a little patience. Have a little patience.
And they would carry
have
on
a little
the
patience,
sentiment
sir.
To the next
sir,
election.
Have a little patience. This is Article 16 of the Geneva Convention, which applies to war, by the way. Which applies to war, not for peacetime, but for war. And we are, let's make no bones about it. Let's stop pretending that we are living in with a normal neighbor. We're not living with a normal neighbor. Article 16 of the Geneva Convention, Taimur Shamil, please listen carefully.
Please listen carefully.
Each party to the conflict shall facilitate the steps taken to protect the killed against ill treatment. If beheading and mutilation of a soldier is not ill treatment, I don't know what is, Vivek Kaju. And they continue to do this. You were in government service when Captain Saurav Kalia's case happened. That was in the Kargil war. Lance Naik Hemraj was 4 years ago. Today we have a BSF head constable and Naib Subedar Paramjeet Singh. Tomorrow God knows who.
But there is no evidence. How that is the problem.
Oh, you want evidence, Taimur Shamil? The evidence is sitting right next to you on screen. The evidence is that elderly gentleman Harkishan, whose nephew was beheaded.
Indian government to the Pakistani government.
Where is Lance Nayak Hemraj? You tell me, where is Lance Nayak Hemraj? His body came home without a head.
Indian army.
Have some shame, Taimur Shamil. Have some shame. Have some respect. At the end of the day, he too is a human being. At the end of the day, a soldier too has human rights. What has this got to do with BJP Congress?
War with Pakistan.
This happened during the UPA's rule 4 years ago. Get out of this make-believe world that you're living in. Get out of this ostrich mentality. Vivek Kaju.
There is no evidence from the Indian
side. Vivek Kaju.
The Indian people need
please,
to
I'm
know
sorry,
the reality.
I'm sorry.
And they deserve to know
I'm
the reality.
I'm sorry that over the dead body of a slain
Zaka,
Indian soldier, you have
a Pakistani
guest asking
is
for
there
evidence. For
evidence. You got the dead body.
I'm sorry.
Why?
I'm sorry.
Pakistan might
I'm
have
sorry.
Given
I feel.
A bit of
I feel
response,
sorry
but
for
there
you.
Is no evidence
I have
that
no
Pakistan
other. I have
how
no
can
other
Pakistan
words.
Do it
just sorry and shame. That's it.
Region.
Sorry and shame. Vivek Kaju.
Switch him off.
Vivek Kaju. Vivek Kaju. Yeah, Vivek Kaju.
I think all that we need to remind our Pakistani guest is the savagery and the genocide which the Pakistani army perpetrated on its then own people in Bangladesh, in what
yes.
is now Bangladesh and what was then East Bengal in 1971. This is an army which indulges as a matter of policy
yes.
on the most heinous crimes. And that is its record. Can he deny the Pakistani army's shameful record in Bangladesh? In 1971. So therefore, to say that this is a professional army which follows the codes and the laws of war is futile. Now the question is, what do we do about this? We are locked, unfortunately, with a neighbor that doesn't respect these norms and therefore and which practices terrorism and low intensity warfare.
I have
always held the view that the only answer to and the only response to low intensity warfare is low intensity warfare.
Yes, yes.
As a nation,
yes.
Until and unless we accept that proposition, we will not succeed in curbing the Pakistanis.
Pay back the Pakistanis in a language they understand. Pay back the Pakistanis in a language they understand. So if they're going to bleed us by 1,000 cuts, bleed them by 10,000. Bleed them in Balochistan. Bleed them in Sindh. bleed them in the northern areas, bleed them in the Punjab. And Taimur Shamil,
and we have you the come to the show, to so.
You come to the show, Taimur Shamil, and you have the audacity, sir, I'm sorry to say this, you have the audacity to ask for proof. You want proof,
is there any proof
of a dead Indian soldier? Why don't you listen to their family? Why don't you listen to their family? I am going to play out for you Captain Ayush Yadav's father. You know how old he was? Taimur, you know how old Captain Ayush was? Captain Ayush was 26 years old. How old are you?
What about the innocent children?
How old are you?
Toddlers.
How old are you, sir? He had more of a life to live than you do. He had more of a life to live than you do. And you know what your people did to him? They killed him.
India towards war with Pakistan.
Can I play out Captain Ayush's
father? BJP is pushing.
Quiet, please. You know nothing about the BJP or the Congress.
This has
nothing to do with the BJP or the Congress. One second. Can I just play out Captain Ayush's father? He spoke to us last week. His son was just 26 years of age, was killed in Kupwara. And he was killed under the cover of stone pelting by some cowards there in the Kashmir Valley. I want to play out what Captain Ayush's father had to tell us. And then I'll come back to Taimur Shamil, the man who's asking for evidence.
Decision to hard lene hi padega, government baaj nahi legi kar legi. Lena to padega hi padega. Aise lachar DC se hato bachcho se kaam nahi chalne wala. Kabhi bhi nahi chalta hai, na chalega. Aap linger on to kar sakte hain kisi cheez ko. Kisi samasya ko linger on kar dein aap. बस साल छः महीने बढ़ा देंगे, आप सोच देंगे मैं चले जाऊँगा, अगली गवर्नमेंट देखेगी, तो इससे हल नहीं होना है, इसको किसी ना किसी को तो एक्शन लेना ही लेना है, सॉलिड एक्शन लेना ही पड़ेगा.
This, by the way, was last week, Taimur Shamil. That's the father of a dead captain. One second. I'm not done yet. Taimur Shamil, I'm not done yet. That was last week. That was last week. Today.
Who mutilated the body?
Today. Head Constable Prem Sagar of the BSF. Why don't we play out his family's reaction?
The real issue Mr. Evidence,
the real issue is Kashmir. Why don't you listen? Why don't you listen to what Head Constable Prem Sagar's family had to say today? Can we play that out, please?
जिस तरीके से वो लोग किए हैं, उसी तरीके से हमारी फौज उनके साथ में उनका भी छत्र करके और सर काट करके लाए.
You have Head Constable Prem Sagar's family reacting today, saying, just like your army does, we have to retaliate, behead Pakistani regulars and bring them back. You have the father of a dead captain speaking to us last week, saying his young son's death needs to be avenged. The real issue, Taimur Shamil, is the death of these soldiers in the most dastardly, in the most brutal, in the most inhuman fashion. You should feel ashamed that your army resorts to this kind of third-degree torture. Why don't you condemn it, Taimur? Why don't you condemn it that the Pakistan army is resorting to this kind of third-degree torture?
Innocent Kashmiris.
It doesn't behove an army.
What do you think about
it? It suddenly doesn't behove an army.
That were killed. The innocent schoolgirls that were killed by the Indian army.
It behoves ISIS. That's what it behoves.
Or so many women that are raped by the Indian army. Why don't you see that?
Major General.
Zaka. Today, I want to tell your friends whom you have invited from the western borders and to the public that side, I feel pity about them.
Yes.
I feel sympathetic towards them.
Yes.
Today, they have an army which is not a professional army, which is a terrorist army on the world.
Not yes. about Kashmir,
right?
Sir.
They will decimate. They have never owned up their savagery.
They never owned up their savagery
in 1971. They never owned up their own soldiers in Kargil in 1999. They will never own up their barbaric attack.
And
today the Zalimistan state is at the verge of decimation from the map. And the Indian army, and Indian army will have the honor of decimating Pakistan from the world map. Once again, like East Pakistan.
Jaiveer Shergill wants to come in.
Only if wishes were horses.
Jaiveer Shergill.
It happened in 71.
It happened in 71, may I remind
again.
You. It happened
wait
in 71.
And watch. Wait and watch.
Jaiveer Shergill.
Atrocity has to reach its zenith first. Jaiveer. And you are there almost.
Firstly, sir, we'll hear you out. Firstly, let me make it clear to the Pakistani guest that sir, please stop addressing us BJP as Congress. In your presence, we speak in one voice as India.
Absolutely.
For our nation, we might bear different flags. BJP as Congress. But
absolutely.
When I
applaud you for that. I applaud you for that.
Second. Second.
Daimur, please have some patience. Yeah. He's been waiting for so long. Can he just make his point, please?
You.
Yes, he didn't interrupt you.
I didn't interrupt you. You are asking about evidence. What kind of an establishment are you who don't even respect your own dead soldiers? Your soldiers were found dead belonging to Northern Infantry in Kargil with ID cards and your general refused to take their body. Yes. So your past record shows barbarity and savagery rather than discipline and honor is the hallmark of Pakistan Army. Hear me down, calm down. Now I'll tell you the law on this. Calm down.
What is happening?
It is the International Convention and protocol.
What is happening in Delhi?
I will answer you on that also. It is international convention and protocol that the dead have to be returned with honor. Article 34 of the additional protocol of 1977, Article 15 of the first Geneva Convention, and as Zaka said, Article 16 of the Geneva Convention. Now,
what if you know so much,
India's
Article
response
sudden,
should
why
be this.
Do you provoke Pakistan
now,
Army
India's
on
response
the LC?
Should be this. I know Pakistan is provoking India because you want to maintain your political supremacy in your own country.
Well,
but let
we
me tell you, sir,
the Pakistani
India
side
will change
India
the degree and magnitude
the world's
of its
attention
response,
from Kashmir.
So it acts as a long-term deterrent for your country.
India
I have no
wants to distract
I
the world's attention
you.
From Kashmir.
A nation which lost 300 kids. Zaka, they lost 300 kids in terrorist attack in Peshawar. Still
and
they
what
are feeding terrorists.
When the army
still they are feeding
is attacking
terrorists.
The ambulances
so an army,
and hospitals in
so
Kashmir. What do you think about that,
which
sir?
Is ready to sacrifice their own citizens for keeping their funding
and
alive from different quarters can have no
because
mindset,
of the BJP
no
government
sense of war.
Is Daimur.
Now let me
India in a
stop telling
Daimur.
BJP government.
Daimur.
Say
Let's...
India. Say
no, no,
India.
One sec, one
stop
second.
Saying BJP government. Say India.
BJP.
One second.
BJP
one
government.
Second,
this
one
BJP
second.
Government is different from the previous
one second,
BJP. We don't
one
have
time
George
mode.
Fernandez anymore.
We are
time
all
mode.
One.
Just
you are
anymore.
Dealing with India.
Let me make this very clear to you.
Or BJP.
Let me make this very clear to you, Taimur Shamil.
And RSS.
Don't try
Taimur
to differentiate
Shamil,
what
let me make this very clear to you.
We will teach you a lesson as in India.
And I want to reiterate this. When it comes to our national security, when it comes to our foreign policy, there is no BJP Congress. I want you and everybody else
That's
in Pakistan to hear
this
loud
this
and
time,
clear, Taimur Shamil. I don't think you know more about
India.
The national security and foreign policy
this
of this country than I do. And if you don't, why don't you just shut up and listen to me?
For many Indians.
You have no idea. You don't speak on behalf of Indians, all right? You have no idea. So
That's
why don't you zip
think.
Up
the
and listen to me for 5 seconds?
What is happening
why
in
don't you
India?
Zip up and listen to me for 5 seconds, okay? You have no idea about this country when it comes to national security, when it comes to
idea.
Foreign policy, when it comes to responding to the Pakistan Army's dastardly, despicable act. We speak in one voice. We are not like your army
in
and civilians speaking
why don't you
in forked
speak
tongues.
In one word when the
we are not like your army and
Kashmir.
Civilians speaking in forked
why don't
tongues.
You tell people about
That's
what is
for Nawaz Sharif and Mr. Bajwa. That is not for us, Taimur. Let's get this
Kashmir.
Absolutely dead straight. When it comes to national security, when it comes to responding to dastardly Pakistani acts, we are one. We were one in 65. We were one in 71, we were one in 1999, and we continue to be one in 2017. All right?
One in killing
it's as simple as that.
In Rajasthan.
It is as simple as that.
One in killing people in Mumbai.
Vivek Kaju.
You worry about your
This is dangerous.
Vivek Kaju.
You worry about Peshawar, you worry about Bachcha Khan University, you worry about Quetta.
Exactly.
Don't tell us what we need to do in our nation.
Exactly.
Well, if
300 kids
about
died
that.
In our nation,
if I were to open,
what we
if I were to open Vivek Kaju, the Pandora's box
want,
of what the Pakistan Army
no support,
has
stop
done
supporting the terrorists.
In Balochistan, what the Pakistan Army has
stop,
done
stop
in
supporting,
Sindh,
stop supporting
what the Pakistan
DGP.
Army has done in the northern areas, the people who have been pushed out because of this thing called the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, what the Pakistanis have done to Mashal Khan. I'm sure Taimur, my friend, will have no answers to that. But Vivek Kaju.
And Christians and Muslims,
I,
what
yeah,
they have done is that you have
Zaka,
made.
I think
the politicians
think
and people who have killed.
Vivek Kaju.
Well, our Pakistani guest, I don't know why he's going on. He's not allowing anyone else to speak. I think the real issue at the moment is the timing of this incident. Why are the Pakistanis indulging in such kind of behavior at this stage? Of course, the army is what it is. An army which, as my colleagues on the panel have said, which does not even collect its dead.
Yes.
As was demonstrated during Kargil, is an army without shame. It has no honor. But the question is, why have they done it now? To that, I believe, I think Bajwa has to establish himself, and he is sending signals both to Nawaz Sharif and the civilian leadership in Pakistan,
yes,
and to India, that he is a macho general in line with his predecessors, and that ultimately he will decide the nature and fate of India-Pakistan
that
relations.
Is right.
And our government and Mr. Modi, I believe, has the stamina and the strength to tell them that he will not decide, that we too have cards to play, and it is high time that we as a nation resolve that we'll play cards. It will be a long drawn out struggle.
Yes, you know, GVL, the point
that
is
struggle
this
has to be taken, and the as I submitted we've got to go in for low intensity
the
counter warfare.
The point is this, GVL. Yesterday the Pakistani army chief was at the line of control. He spoke to his troops, and within 24 hours we have this happening to two of our braves. My point is very simple. No, GVL, one second. No, my question is to GVL, one second, please. GVL, my question is this. The Pakistanis have had this strategy of bleeding India by 1,000 cuts. They've been doing it for the last 25 years. We have lost many, many, way too many of our braves to this lopsided, barbarian, inhuman policy. What is our response, sir? What is our response?
No, Zaka, I think we have really surprised them on many occasions. We have really put them last 3 years, the Pakistan, we have really started off, Mr. Modi has started his term extending an arm, a hand of friendship to Pakistan. And but the way the backstab subsequently and have not come good on their promises made in Ufa. I think it has been, we have exerted continuously pressure on them. We have also surprised them. Surgical strikes itself took them by a complete shock. I think a former army chief who was expected to get an extension was denied extension because of that failure. That itself was an admission.
Okay.
The manner in which we isolated them in entire SAARC region, when was it? When did it happen ever in the past,
you know,
that entire region boycotted Pakistan?
You know,
so certainly we have had our successes. But you cannot expect a rogue army to keep quiet and not venture out something or other.
The Pakistan
and this will
army,
also be met with an equally stiff response.
The Pakistan army is so shameless that one of the longest standing allies that Pakistan has had is Turkey. Today the Turkish president was in India as a state guest, and they even overlooked what an embarrassment this would be to a visiting guest. Turkey is one of your longest standing allies, Taimur. The Turkish president is here today. You didn't even have
a
basic courtesy that one of your longest standing friends is visiting India. And this is what your bad action team does.
Let's not talk.
You should be embarrassed. You should be embarrassed, sir.
Let's not.
You should be embarrassed to say that this is what the Pakistan army did when one of your longest standing friends is visiting India.
To the issue of Kashmir.
You should be ashamed of that.
Let's talk about Kashmir then.
No, you should be ashamed of the fact, Taimur Shamil, that when one of your longest standing friends You have shamed the Turkish president. That's what you have done.
He has made a statement. That they want.
No, I'm sure. After what he has seen today, he will have a rethink. I am absolutely certain when that the Turkish president will have a rethink after seeing firsthand here in India what his good friends in Pakistan are up to. I'm more than reasonably sure that he will have a rethink.
Erdogan and Turkey are very mature and they know what India is doing at the moment.
We should not forget Pakistan is at the verge of peril. The whole world recognizes that Pakistan has become a fountainhead of terrorism in South Asia. We don't have to do anything. The Pakistan will vanish. And I think the Indian Army will have the honor of decimating Pakistan from the face of the world.
I ask tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the biggest crisis that the world is facing right now is in the Korean Peninsula. Every country in the globe has come around to this view that North Korea needs to be treated like a rogue nation. How long, and I want to ask this to everybody on the panel, how long, dear sirs, before the world comes to the same conclusion about Pakistan? This is a rogue country. This is not a normal country. This is not a country that believes in normal, decent behavior.
The world has already realized.
No, the world will soon realize,
what is
Taimur,
happening Kashmir, Zaka,
that you are part of the axis of evil. You need to be treated like how
we
North Korea is being treated.
TTP,
like a rogue nation.
ETIM,
like a rogue nation, like a pariah state.
Single-handedly,
that is how
Pakistan
you need to be treated.
All these pariah states. Individuals and groups.
Javier Shergill.
But unlike India, we weren't financing any TTP, any Taliban or any terrorist
Zaka,
group.
This incident, sir, hear me out. This incident warrants global condemnation. India needs to ensure that the Pakistan is militarily and economically suffocated from all
the
possible angles. Then only we will start
North Korea.
Third, we have to start domestically. I will tell you about Kashmir also. Why are you like
Delhi?
A kitten on a tin roof? Why are you jumping like a kitten on a hot tin roof? I will answer you in Kashmir also. Calm down. I've just started. Third, domestically, we have to ensure we start the procedure again to term Pakistan as a terror state. We have to start the states feel that
the
economically we don't want to trade with them, and then
the
their
Indian,
people
Indian
from that
Army
side will feel the pressure.
Kashmir is the terrorist.
Fourth, are you talking about
but
Kashmir, sir? Let
Army
me tell you, Balochistan, 18,638 people have vanished from Balochistan. 6,000 people are detained by Pakistani people without taking
girls,
them to court. You're teaching our country as human rights violations. India needs to up its ante, increase its degree and magnitude of our response so that our response acts as a long deterrence measure.
That is the issue.
Pakistan is on a self-destructive mode.
My point is, stop lying to the people of India.
Pakistan is on a self-destructive mode.
Taimur, you should stop lying to yourself. You know, I'll tell you why. One second, Taimur, you should stop lying to yourself.
Zaka, I'm
if you
to the
one second. Hang on. You should stop lying to yourself. If you're living in some sort of misconception that, you know, if Kashmiris were to have a referendum, they'll suddenly join you. They'll suddenly join Pakistan. They'll suddenly join this rogue country, this country that should be treated like
my
a pariah state. Then you're lying to yourself, Taimur Shamil.
And so are the millions of other Pakistanis,
the Hafiz Saeeds and the Masood Azhars. If you think that the Kashmiris will join you, then please, you're living in some daydream. Taimur Shamil. You should knock yourself off this daydream. You're living in some distorted reality. Stop lying to yourself.
Kashmir
is, was, and will always be an integral part of India. Period.
Kashmir is what they want.
Full stop. Period. That's the end of the story. Kashmir will, has, and will always be an integral part of India. Stop living in
that's
your daydream. Stop
that's
living
that is
in this
so many
concocted
in, so many
reality that you've imagined
this
in your head, Taimur
is,
Shamil.
This
distorted reality
that
you've imagined in your head and sold to your people by your army and your deep state. Get out. Get out of this distorted reality. Wake up from this distorted reality. But I want to go back to Mr. Harkishan. Harkishan ji, ये जो हमारे पाकिस्तानी मेहमान हैं वो कह रहे हैं कि पाकिस्तानी फौज जो है वो ऐसे हरकतें नहीं करती, वो शहीदों का गला नहीं काटते, वो ऐसे हरकत नहीं करते हैं। आप ये बताइए, आप बताइए बताइए,
पाकिस्तानी हरकत ना करते फिर कौन कर रहा हो इन्हें? सुन जी, ये पाकिस्तानी हरकत ना करें तो फिर और कौन कर रहा हो? पाकिस्तानी तो कर रहे हैं।
तैमूर साहब का तो मुंह बंद हो गया, उनके पास तो जवाब ही नहीं है। अगर पाकिस्तानी ये नहीं कर रहे तो कौन कर रहे हैं साहब?
से पूछिए।
नहीं, कौन कर रहे हैं आप बताइए? अगर पाकिस्तानी नहीं कर रहे हैं तो कौन कर रहे हैं?
अपनी सरकार
के पास, आपके पास तो कोई जवाब ही नहीं है।
वो कैसे आपका मुंह बंद हो गया?
बताइए हरकिशन जी,
पाकिस्तानी अंदर कैसे आ गए?
हरकिशन जी ये बताइए, पिछले साल
कौन कर रहे हो? जब पाकिस्तानी हरकत ना कर रहे तो फिर यहाँ कौन कर रहा हुआ बताओ?
पिछले साल
अपनी सरकार से पूछिए जो लोगों से झूठ बोलती है।
One second, my question is to him, not to you, Taimur. हरकिशन जी, पिछले साल ये सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक हुई, मोदी जी की सरकार ने सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक किए, लेकिन उससे भी बात नहीं बनी। आपको क्या लगता है, दूसरा सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक होनी चाहिए या कुछ और होना चाहिए?
देखो, जब मोदी जी की सरकार पे ना कछु बनना हो तो फिर और कोई का करे हो वहां बताओ? और तुम जो कह रहे हो पाकिस्तानी नागरिक तो और फिर कौन कर रहे हो?
नहीं, आप बताइए, दूसरी सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक हो जाए, क्या क्या चाहते हैं आप? आपके भांजा मर गए, चार साल हो गए,
ये
चार साल तैमूर, वन सेकेंड, आपके भांजा मरे चार साल हो गए, आप ये बताइए क्या क्या किया जाए?
चार साल से कुछ नहीं भयो ना, कोई 10 ला मेंगे, कोई 2 ला मेंगे, कोई 15 लाएंगे, वहाँ एक हो ना आयो और दो शहीदन को और सिर काट दियो,
आर पार की लड़ाई हो जाए इस बार,
बताओ?
यही चाहेंगे?
लड़ाई आर पार की न हो, ना, अब जब तक लड़ाई आर पार की न होगी, जब तक हमारे हिंदुस्तान को कोई मजबूत ना बने वो।
ओके, दैट इज,
जब तक लड़ाई आर पार की न होगी, जब तक कोई ना बने कच्छ, लड़ाई आर पार की होनी चाहिए।
दैट इज द अंकल ऑफ अ डेड सोल्जर, it's been 4 years,
and that is the dilemma.
I would like to say something
we are telling
to
people
Mr.
at the grassroots Har-Kishan level that we should go for war.
One sec, he wants to tell something to Mr. Harkishan from Har-Kishan soldier
ji,
to soldier.
Hum pakistaniyon ke sar kayarta se kaat ke nahi layenge, hum ek professional fauj se hain, hum chhati taan ke unse ladenge aur unko khatam karenge, ye aap bharosa rakhiye hamari fauj ke upar, hamari sarkar ke upar. हम कायरता वाला हरकत नहीं करेंगे। आपका भांजा एक शहीद था और एक जवान आदमी था हिंदुस्तान आर्मी का, उसके साथ कायरता हुई है, मगर हम कायरता नहीं करेंगे। हम एक जिम्मेवार फौज हैं और हम एक जिम्मेवार देश हैं। हम पाकिस्तान की तरह एक गुंडा देश नहीं है। हौसला रखिए, बदला मिलेगा।
वो तो तैयारी बात सही है, फिर ऐसे मरवाओ करेंगे ने तो फिर ये जवान कहां से आएंगे?
हिमराज जी, मामला ये है कि आपके यहाँ फौजियों को वहां पे मरवाया जा रहा है, वो जाने खो रहे हैं
किशन जी, हमें मालूम है, हमारे जवान एक बहुत मुश्किल काम कर रहे हैं। मैं खुद उनके साथ वहां पे रहा हूं, जिस इलाके में ये हुआ है मैं खुद था वहां पे, और मुझे दुख होता है जब हमारे जवान शहीद होते हैं, मगर हम कायर नहीं बन सकते, हम रोग नहीं बन सकते, हम गुंडे नहीं बन सकते।
इसीलिए
ये हमको ये हिसाब हमको अपनी शराफत का देना पड़ेगा और देते रहेंगे।
ओनली हरकिशन, कट ऑफ तैमूर ऑडियो प्लीज, कट इट ऑफ, ही इज नॉट इवन मेकिंग सेंस।
आपको मालूम होगा आपके जीवन काल में हुआ है, इस दुनिया के नक्शे से पूर्वी पाकिस्तान का नाम हट गया, आपकी जिंदगी में वेस्टर्न पाकिस्तान का नाम भी हटेगा, ये एक फौजी का वादा है आपसे, मगर हमारे जवानों को मजबूत होना पड़ेगा, हमारे जवानों की फैमिलीज को मजबूत होना पड़ेगा, हमें मजबूत होना पड़ेगा।
वो देख लें जो यह वादा कर रहे हैं तुम,
ये मेरे दिल की दुआ है, ये होगा
जी,
ये जरूर होगा, या पाकिस्तान बदलेगा या पाकिस्तान खत्म होगा।
Alright.
चलो हम तो हम यही चाह रहे हैं, या पाकिस्तान को तो बिल्कुल खत्म करो तुम, यह
होगा
पाकिस्तान
होगा।
को तो नाम ही खत्म करो,
as they say in Pakistan, इंशाल्लाह। hoga. We'll leave it at that. Thank you very much. Thank you very much to all our panelists. All I'll say is this. All I'll say is this as we wrap up. We have had one too many of our soldiers, young men, like Captain Saurav Kalia, like Lance Nayak Hemraj, and now the latest, the Naib Subedar and the head constable. One too many of our men have gone in the most horrific, in the most barbaric way possible. There will be retribution for this. There will be retaliation for this in a manner and in a language that Pakistan understands. But, like Major General said, we're not a coward force. The Indian Army is not a coward force. We don't hit from behind and run back in. We face them chin up, hit them where it hurts, and we come back with our chests and our chins held high. Quick break. As we take a break, the results of our online poll. When we come back, all the other stories that have made the headline. And while Pakistan betrays us at the border, their proxies are wreaking havoc on the ground in the Kashmir Valley. Terrorists attacked a cash van belonging to the Jammu and Kashmir Bank on the Shopian-Kulgam road and fled with the cash that was in the truck. Five people, including an ASI and two bank officials, were killed in the attack. It's another instance of the bloody summer that is continuing in the Kashmir Valley. And in case you want to check out more on that story or whatever else has been happening in the valley today, you can go to our website. It's news18.com. From me, Zakir Jacob, and the rest of the team, thanks for your time. On the other side, Viewpoint with Bhupinder Chaudhary.